Hey friends, thank you so much for tuning in, joining with us here tonight. Hey, did you like that intro video that gets played each week? See, that's a little short little video that gives you a kind of like a little behind the scenes look of what happens within the ministry and some of those things that we have going on. Now, I know some of you actually know firsthand what we have going on, but for those who don't know, see, that video right there, it showed our Night to Shine prom that we partner with the Tim Tebow Foundation, and we've done it for 6 years now. The video highlighted some of those key moments, those special moments for some of our participants and the people volunteering. But also, one thing I want you to take special note of is, did you see the part that had all the faces on the screen? That's our Sunday morning 9 a.m. Bible school class. That's our Sunday school class. And that happens on Zoom. Now, I know that it's a little bit different than what many of us are used to because, see, we're used to being on campus. But since this quarantine hit, COVID-19, we've been on the platform Zoom. And you know what? In the message, Andy's gonna touch on it in just a little bit, but how joyful is it for us to know, you and me to know, that we still get to connect with each other, even though it's in a different way, we still get to see each other every single Sunday morning. So the best way to connect with us is on our Zoom platform on Sunday mornings. The link will be at the bottom for you to be able to go to the page, you'll be able to click on it, and if you need help, ask your parents or ask somebody in your house just to kind of help you out. And guess what? You're going to be able to see maybe a lot of familiar faces and maybe even some new faces if you are here with us for the first time. But we'd love the opportunity for you to connect with us to connect with you in that way. You know what else you could do is, see, this is our YouTube channel for the Disabilities Ministry here at Crossroads. We'd love it if you went ahead and hit that subscribe button and followed us along on our channel. And also hit that notification button. That's that little bell icon right next to it. What that does is it lets you know anytime we're going live and we're premiering a video or maybe Andy has uploaded a new video, type in the chat how many of you enjoy all the videos that Andy's uploading that we get to see team members and we get to see our friends on the channel, right? Another thing, I know this feels like a lot, but what would ministry be if there wasn't a whole lot, right? Well, there's a share button right down below. We'd love it if you shared our channel with all your friends. Not just what's happening tonight, but just the channel, any video that you like. You can hit that share button and you could text it, you could send it in an email, or you could even post it on your own Facebook page. But we'd love for you to share it with your friends so that way they can be as blessed as you are in being connected with us in that way. But as I mentioned, tonight, Andy is going to be sharing with you another message, a great message on the fruits of the Spirit. And tonight, he's going to be touching on the topic of joy. And I can't wait to hear all that it is that he has to share with you and with me. But let's go ahead and let's pray, okay? Let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, thank you so much, Father God, for your word. I thank you for just giving us your word in such a way that it is meaningful and applicable for all of us, Father. It doesn't matter how much schooling we have. It doesn't matter our background. Father, you've made your word in the simplest of form and in the complex of form, Father, so that it reaches everyone. So I pray that whoever's tuned in with us right now or maybe watching on another day, I pray, Father God, that they're blessed, and I pray that they experience an immense, an amazing amount of joy inside themselves and in their life. So I lift this up to you in your name. Amen. Hey, everyone, let's go ahead and welcome up our very own Andy.
Hi, friends. This week, we are continuing the series Fruit of the Spirit. And so far, we have talked about what the fruit of the Spirit is. Last week, Pastor Jennifer spoke about what I think is the most important fruit of the Spirit, which is love. And this week, I get to talk about joy. Did I look joyful? I hope I look joyful. That was the point. But anyway, before I continue on that, I want to review just a little bit for those viewers who are watching with us for the first time on this series. And I would encourage you all to go back and watch the first two, so that way you can get more of an understanding of what we're talking about. So, the fruit of the Spirit. What is it? It's not actual fruit that you can pick off of a tree and eat. The fruit of the Spirit symbolizes something different, which means it means something else. You receive the fruit of the Spirit when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. Then the Holy Spirit comes to live inside you in your heart, and He is the one that produces the fruit of the Spirit in your life. And it comes out in the form of how we talk, how we speak to other people, and how we behave to other people around us. Now you can find the fruit of the Spirit in Galatians, in a book of the Bible in Galatians chapter 5:22. And the Apostle Paul says this, "But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in a person's life: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against these kinds of things." So that's pretty awesome, right? We receive those free gifts, that fruit of the Spirit, when we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And the Holy Spirit is the one that produces those from our heart. And those are free to us, friends. So my next question would be, what is joy? Like, you might think you know the answer, and I thought I knew the answer, but let's find out. Let's dig into that. So Webster's Dictionary defines joy as a state of happiness or joy. Now that sounds correct, right? Happiness and joy kind of meaning the same thing, like you can interchange them. But it's actually incorrect, friends. See, according to the Bible, happiness's definition of joy is different from our world's definition of joy. So, the thing about happiness is that happiness, you receive it from the people and the world around you, your external, your everything external, in the form of the people in your lives and in the form of things and situations. So, as long as the people and those things in your life do things that you like and do things that make you feel good, you stay happy. But as soon as someone says something you don't like, or you fall into a situation that doesn't make you feel good, your happiness goes away just like that. So you see, happiness is a temporary thing. Doing things to make you happy only lasts for a little while. Now, I'm not saying that doing things to make you happy is a bad thing. That is not what I'm saying. In fact, doing things to make you happy can be really fun. Which brings me to my question. I have a question. What is one thing that you know always seems to make you happy, regardless of your mood? Go ahead and put it in the chat, or you can just yell it out. I would love to read them. By the way, if you're watching on our premiere, I'm probably in the chat with you right now, and I can respond to whatever it is you say. So go ahead and answer. Okay. So now, you guys want to see something that makes me happy, which I think is super fun? All right, so before I do, I want to explain a little bit about it. So I have been watching this YouTuber for a while now, this guy that makes YouTube videos. I've been following his channel, and every time I watch his videos, it doesn't matter how many times I watch him, I have a huge smile on my face while I watch. He just makes me laugh, and my wife even thinks I'm a little weird because I watch his videos over and over again. So check this out and let me know what you think.
Hey, Mufasa. Ready to spread your vibes? Spread that wind. Around the world.
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 Let's go. 3, 2, 1, go.
Wasn't his video fun, you guys? I really hope you enjoyed it. So his name is Mufasa, and he is an amazing dancer. And I watch his videos over and over again, like I said before, and I never seem to get tired of them. They always seem to make me happy. So I hope you guys have something like that in your lives. It's a pretty cool thing to have. But anyway, moving on to joy. So what is joy according to the Bible? How do we achieve joy according to the Bible? Well, I can tell you that the way that we do that is by focusing our attention, choosing to focus on God. So it says here in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 to 18, it says this, "Always be joyful, never stop praying, be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who belongs to Christ Jesus." Now I actually forgot to mention something, friends. I want to make it a point that when we focus our attention on God, there is one part that we have that I forgot to mention before. We have a choice. We have the ability to choose to be joyful. So I'm going to read that verse again. "Always be joyful, never stop praying, be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who belongs to Christ Jesus. So, it says in that verse to always be joyful, to never stop praying, to be thankful for everything in all circumstances, because God wants that for us. He wants us to do that. Now, I want to point out something, that God wouldn't tell us to do something if he didn't think that we couldn't do it, so that we could do it. And even if we couldn't do it on our own, if we ask God for help and we pray to him, he will help us do it, friends. So you could be confident in knowing that. But how do we always be joyful? How do we accomplish that? Well, I can tell you that it doesn't happen overnight. It's not something you pray for and some miracle happens and then you're just joyful all the time. That's not how it works. There is a part that we have to play, friends. And that part is that we have to form some healthy habits that will help us to be more joyful throughout our day. So the next question would be, what habits should I start doing that will help me to be more joyful? Well, the answer was actually in that verse that I read. Now I'm gonna read it a third time. So if you know the answer, go ahead and put it in the chat, but I'm gonna read it again to see if you catch it. I'll give you a little hint. Always be joyful, never stop praying, be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who belongs to Christ Jesus. So what is it, friends? The answer is to be thankful. To be thankful in as many circumstances as you can. See, when we are thankful, friends, we take our attention away from those negative emotions, those negative feelings like being angry or fearful or upset in some way. We take the attention away from that and we focus on good things in our lives, things that make us feel good. And it really helps, friends. So what are some things that we can be thankful for? What are the things that we should be thankful for? The most important things. Well, like I said before, focusing our attention on God, but specifically, Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He came down to this earth to die on the cross for our sins so that we could live in eternity with him forever in a place without suffering, without pain, and we would have perfect bodies. Don't you want a perfect body? I sure do want a perfect body because my body is far from perfect right now. But that's one thing you can be thankful for, but there are hundreds and hundreds more. Let me give you an example in my life. So I am thankful for my loving wife. I'm thankful that I get to come home to her and she supports me in everything that I do. I'm thankful for a family that I have, my parents who are very supportive of me. I'm thankful that they're still healthy, that I have a roof over my head, that I have food on the table to eat every day. I'm thankful that I get to work in this amazing church, Crossroads Disabilities Ministry. I'm thankful that I get to know all of you guys, that I know you personally, well, most of you. I mean, I can go on and on about these things. So it's easy to be thankful. And I don't know if you knew this, but every good thing in your life, it comes from God, friends. It says right here, in James, the book of James in the Bible, chapter 1:17, it says this, whatever is good and perfect is a gift coming down to us from God our Father, who created all the lights in the heavens. He never changes or casts a shifting shadow. So you see, friends, James says there, and James was the brother of Jesus, by the way, but James says there that every good and perfect gift is coming down to us from God. So it's easy to be thankful to the Lord when you accept this. The Lord puts everything in your life that makes you feel good and appreciative of the beautiful things that you have in your life. Those things come from God. So I would encourage you to do that. Now, I'm not gonna tell you to do something that I don't already do. So I'm going to tell you a little story about what I do these days. Every morning, I get up about 5 o'clock in the morning to 5:30, and I make a point to spend time with the Lord. So I get up, I get whatever drink I'm planning to drink, it's probably coffee or something like that, and then I head to one of my rooms, and I spend time with the Lord praying, I study his word, I study the Bible, and I also sing praises to him. And yes, I do sing to him. It doesn't sound pretty. It's more of a joyful noise, all right? Don't hate, but I do sing praises to him. But the thing I want to point out about that is that when I pray to him, I don't only ask him for things. I don't only ask him for help in whatever situations I may have. I also make a point to give thanks for everything that he provides for me. And I've been doing that now for a while. that it's become a healthy habit. And now I don't only do it during the day in the morning, I do it throughout my day without even thinking about it. So when times come when I have a negative emotion or a negative thought in my head, right away my mind goes to being thankful, to start focusing on those good things that God has provided for me in my life. And it has helped me tremendously, friends. It really has. So when COVID-19 started and we all were not able to do the normal things that we were accustomed to doing, it actually hit me really hard. Not everybody knows this, but when quarantine took effect and we had to stay in our homes and we couldn't do those things, I got a little bit depressed, friends. And I cried out to God for help. I asked him what I could possibly do to overcome this, like what was going on. So the Lord answered me and he told me that, Andy, you have placed those things that make you happy before me. And as soon as quarantine took those things away from you, your life seemed like it was crumbling, and that's why you feel the way that you feel right now. That's why you're depressed. And he told me that, Andy, you have a choice right now. You have a choice to spend this time during quarantine to draw closer to me, to get to know me better, to put me first, or you can continue doing what you're doing and stay miserable. And I made the choice to get up from that day on every morning and spend time with the Lord first. And it has helped me so much, friends. I can tell you right now that as soon as I started doing that, my God got bigger and my problems, they got smaller. So now I don't lose sleep over things like COVID-19, over things like the scary stuff that you can hear in the news. There's a lot of scary stuff going on right now, friends. But I don't lose sleep over it and I don't let the fear control me. Now, I'm not trying to say that COVID-19 is not real. I'm not trying to say that it's not dangerous. It's very dangerous and it is very real. And we should all practice social distancing and wearing our masks. But what I'm saying is that when I drew nearer to God, I didn't let that fear control my life anymore. I put God first because I know that God is in control of it all. So I would encourage you to do that, friends. Psalms chapter 16:11 says this, "You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasure of living with you forever." King David wrote that. King David wrote that about God. And it was the same David that took down Goliath the giant with a sling and a rock because he had such a strong faith and relationship with God. And I can tell you that as soon as I started spending more time with the Lord, I experienced those things that he was talking about there. The Lord showed me how to live. He showed me the way of life and he granted me more joy throughout my day. So I just wanted to point that out. Another thing about joy that I learned, friends, that I'm not sure you know, is that joy has power. Did you know that? Joy is powerful. In Nehemiah 8:10, it says this, "Don't be dejected and sad, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." You see that, friends? It says there that joy has power. Joy is a powerful tool that we can use. Because I don't know if you know this, but Satan, he comes to attack us, and yes, he is real. And when he comes to attack us, he likes to steal our joy. And why does he like to do that? Because when he takes away our joy, it is easier for us to do things that get us into trouble, do things that we might regret later, to fall into sin. So we can use things to help us to be more joyful to combat that. Joy is powerful, and remember that, friends. All right, so now I have a game. Let's bring the spirit up a little bit. Let's focus on some game that I think is pretty funny. It's called Happiness versus Joy. Okay, so I'm gonna say something that makes me happy, and then I'm gonna follow it up with something that is joyful. So, happiness is baked cookies fresh out of the oven. Don't you guys love fresh cookies? I love baked fresh cookies. It's one of my favorite things in the world, honestly. All right, joy is being in a good mood, even though those cookies are a little bit burnt. You ever had that happen? You get burnt cookies. They still taste good, but it's not quite right. Well, I'm grateful that I still have cookies. See, that's a joyful thing. All right, happiness is buying that really cool video game that you've been waiting for a long time to get, and you finally get to play it. Now, I know there are some viewers out there that buy video games and play video games, and I was once like that. So when I finally got to play that game, it made me so happy, man. That's all I wanted to do was play that video game. But as soon as that video game got old, that happiness went away. So joy is not having enough money to get that video game you've wanted, but still being content with the games that you do have. Okay, next one. Happiness is celebrating your birthday with friends and family in person and getting lots of presents. Who doesn't like presents? I love presents. I think I even love presents more during Christmas more than my birthday. So yeah, that definitely makes me happy. Joy is not being able to celebrate your birthday in person with friends and family because of COVID. That darn COVID, right? Yes. But you're still feeling grateful because you got to have maybe a drive-by parade, or you got to have people call you and say happy birthday to you, and you recognize that you have another year of life. All right, last one. Happiness is seeing all your friends and your family at church and being able to worship God in person. We can all look forward to that. That's coming soon, friends. Joy is not being able to worship in person because of COVID and the quarantine, but still being grateful because we can still do things like that on Zoom, on YouTube. We're still able to connect in other ways. That's joy, friends. See, when you focus your attention on the good things that you already have, the good things in your life that you have now, that's how you experience more joy. Let's pray. Father in heaven, I want to thank you so much for this opportunity to share this message and what I've learned. I pray that if there are some people watching right now that have not yet experienced joy in their life, that they start forming some healthy habits today, that they understand and you open their minds and their hearts to experiencing more joy from this day forward. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.